We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The praise of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My name is Father Yan Lee, parish priest, and I'd like to, on behalf of the Lazzaro family, especially on behalf of Sam's wife, Carrie, and his two lovely daughters, Amelia, and also Evie, and his mother, Frances, and his brother, Greg. Unfortunately, he was straight, cannot be here. And I'd like to welcome you all, relatives and friends. So many of you have been touched by him and by his life, being here today and joining the funeral prayer for Sam. We know that the family is so touched by your presence. It was like the presence of the risen Christ in the midst at this time. At the loss of beautiful man, beautiful husband, father, son, and brother, and relatives and friends, we can express how much our loss for him. We turn to the God who raised up the dead, the God who is truly the God of love, the God of life, the God who saves. And in that God, we come together to pray for him, and we, in that God, we also come together to give thanks for such beautiful gift given to us.
And as a Christian tradition, we continue to use different symbols to remind us that death is not the last word, but life and love are the last word. And our God is truly the God of love, the God of life, the God who saves. So I'm beginning with the sprinkling of the holy water. In the water of baptism, Sam died with Christ and rose with him to a new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. For the lighting of the Paschal candle, I'd like to invite Matthew to come and light the Paschal candle for us. In baptism, Sam received the light of Christ. That light has guided him throughout his life. May he now enjoy the risen life with his risen Lord. And a blessing of the white pole, I'd like to invite Francis and Julie. At his baptism, Sam received a white garment, symbol of his dignity as a child of God. We now cover his coffin with a white cloth in recognition of his fidelity to God throughout his life. And may the Lord not look on any wrong that he may have done during his life, but rather look upon his faithfulness to his God and his love for his family and friends. And we pray that my Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Father, we firmly believe that your Son died and rose to life. We pray for our brother Sam, who has died in Christ, raise him to share the glory of the risen Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated and listen to the word of God.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment should ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they will appear to die. Their going look like a disaster. They are leaving us like annihilation. But they are in peace. They experience punishment as people. Their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them like as a holocaust. When the time has come for his visitation, they will shine out as sparks run through the stubble. So they will. They shall judge nations, rule over peoples, and the Lord's will be the king forever. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. The grace and mercy await those he has chosen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd. Response, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these, you give me comfort.
Lord, my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing.
Lord, is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's house shall I dwell forever and ever.
Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Alleluia, alleluia, I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He who believes in me will not die forever. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Now I'd like to invite Alfio and Wen speak of the beautiful memory of Sam on behalf of Greg, Lazzaro, and also Wen speak on behalf of his wife. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Here today, my name is Alfio. I'm here today to speak on behalf of Greg, Lazzaro, who cannot be here with us. These are his words.
Firstly, I would like to call out to everyone here who has supported Sam through this really difficult time over the past few years. Towards the end, I have seen unwavering support for Sam, and I'm reassured that he felt loved and cared for right till the end. To Kerry and to my mum, Frances, you are both saints. And I know and feel your pain, fear and emotion you both had, that Sam is now in a better place, knowing the true love and care you both showed him. It is really incredible, and Sam is so lucky to have had this much love around him. To my dear brother Sam, where do I begin? I'm so proud of you. As a brother, my first real memories were of you breaking a biscuit and eating the bigger piece. And when I cried, you would give me a whole new biscuit and laugh. I would follow with a big hug and wipe my tears, knowing that you would always keep me in check, but you also cared and looked after me. This followed with many great times, dragging me along with your mates. You know who you are out there. And cementing memories that even today I look upon as some of the best times of my life. So many good times, my brother, with you that I really do thank you for. You've been an amazing father to your two beautiful girls, a loving husband to Carrie, an incredible friend to so many. When you needed something, Sam would never disappoint and would always be there. Sam would always show his best self, even when things were not always going well. He would always be the guy in the room that would share a laugh and look so positively in everything. So dearly loved his friends and family, who today I'm sure are listening to all this. He would always speak of you in many ways, with pride when something was achieved, with sadness when someone was in pain, with admiration, surprise, happiness and love. To Sam, it was always about people. He truly cared for people and showed patience and care with true humility. That's what makes Sam a truly special person and why our hearts are heavy today. I feel so sad today that I cannot be there to share the tears, the story, the laughs and the celebrations of Sam's life. I am so grateful, however, that I know that this will happen with you. Please share your stories, laugh and fill the air with joy and celebrate my brother's life. I know he will want this. The tears will come and are flowing as I write this, but that's okay too. To Amelia and Evie, I want to say to you, your dad may have left us in body, but he will continue to live inside your heart and will be stronger every day. It will be hard for you both and for Mum, but with that much love around you and with the incredible family and friends to support you, you will be comforted, and I'm positive that you will find the strength that Dad has left with you. Your dad would only want the best for you, so take your time and know that by remembering your dad, sharing the good times, it will help the pain. He is incredibly proud of you and always explained to me how constantly enriched his life was. Lastly, for those that knew Sam well, you would know that he loved discovering and exploring the stars. His love for astronomy was infectious, and he would be the one who would get up at 2 a.m. to see the comet or the alignment of some planet. I remember when we were kids, he would make me lie down, look up at the stars for hours, and explain it all to me. Even today, when I find myself looking up at the beautiful night sky, I always think of my brother, wondering what he would see in the heavens. I know that now he's no longer with us. However, looking to the sky on a perfect night, I will think of Sam and all of the memories we had of him. Thank you for this gift, my brother. I love you and will always deeply miss you, and will always be in our hearts and in the stars.
Good morning all, and thank you all for coming. I am Sam's friend and brother-in-law, and I read today on behalf of Kerry, Amelia and Evie. The first time Kerry asked Sam out, he replied, I really need a drink. He then left Kerry because I lived next door. and he came to see me. We had a drink, we hugged it out, and I said to him, "Sam, you know, if this doesn't work out, I'm going to have to say goodbye to my sister." 10 minutes later, he went back. He said yes, he would like to go out with her. Later on, he told her that he would like, he had liked her for a while, but was worried about violating the bro code. After Sam asked Kerry to marry him, she let him know that she cannot cook. She's more Gordon Ramsay's Hell's Kitchen than Jamie Oliver's Mediterranean Feast. And she told him that she cannot clean as well, and that these two things really are not going to get any better. But she did promise him that no one will love him as much as she will, and Sam never forgot her promise. He quoted it back to her several times over their 30 years together. He truly cherished her promise and believed it to his very core. Sam's favourite word was boh. He also liked kiet for Cassie the cat, or pussa, and sealish. He used to love cursing phone scammers. Once they heard him yelling, "I curse you, I curse your family, you will never have a moment's peace until you stop doing this." Sam thought this was amusing. He created a game whilst him and Evie were driving to school. When they spotted a dog, they would yell out, "Mobile mutt, two dogs, multi-mutts, Wi-Fi mutt," if it was a little white dog, "and major muttage," when there was four dogs or more. He loved his red car, the Abarth Spider. He loved driving it with the roof down. When Sam and the girls would watch Essendon play, he'd shout out, "Goal, goal," jumping up and down in front of the couch, high-fiving the girls. He also loved repeating the name, "Tip and Woody, Tip and Woody." His all-time hero was Carl Sagan, an astronomer, astrophysicist, and planetary scientist. Sam would often say, "If I could invite one person to dinner alive or dead, it would be Carl." He loved quoting things from the movies. From The Fifth Element, "It was as is light." From Predator, "If it bleeds, we can kill it." From Terminator, "Sarah Connor." Yes. From Aliens, "Game over, man, game over." And from Galaxy Quest, "And then it exploded." Sam and Mr. Pepe, his Brazilian parrot, they had a weirdly close relationship. I know this bird, and it attacks every visitor that walks into that house. But the bird would snuggle up to Sam, and they would fall asleep together most nights. Sam's passions: science, astronomy, technology, computers. He was brilliant at building and fixing them. Anything around food, particularly his mother's. He especially loved Francis's arancinis and Kerry's lasagna. His remote control planes, he not only loved flying them, but also building them to make them better. He loved skeptic shows and podcasts, anyone disputing flat earthers, stargazing with his awesome large telescope, and going to his Astronomical Society meetings. He loved playing tennis, and when the team especially was his family and close friends. He loved his friends, and above all else, family. Chickens. The man loved anything to do with chickens. They were his all-time favourite animal. He loved sci-fi, TV series and movies. He particularly loved Star Wars and Star Trek, and critiquing movies if they had scientific inaccuracies. He also loved to show off how clever he could be during documentaries and say what they were just about to say, but getting it in first. The family had a tradition of yelling at him, saying, you're ruining it, when he did it. And then they would throw cushions at his head. He had a fantasy of a guinea pig powered go-kart. where one would die and be dragged behind it. He would play his subwoofer way too loud. The family felt like they were vibrating and yelled at him to cut it out. Sam loved any chance to squeeze a penny. He considered it a noble challenge to get a good deal, and he would barter with anybody. Once driving an hour to buy jeans because they were $4 cheaper. And he taught the girls to always ask for a better deal, constantly changing utility providers to do so. He was fascinated with Easter Island because of the carved human figures with their oversized heads. He adored his girls so much. He was a great hands-on dad, teaching them maths and science, about computers and computer games. But on a personal note, we all have our own memories of Sam. And I hope that since his passing, you have found some time to remember them. And hopefully, along with the tears, they have brought a smile to your face. Sam was an amazing friend to all. He always had your best interest at heart. He would always make himself available or have your back when needed. Sam was a man of science, and on behalf of us all, I say, Sam, you have lingered long enough on the shores of the cosmic ocean. You are ready at last to set sail for the stars. We don't know where you're going, but you are now on your way. And to all, he would reply, I have been and will always be your friend. Live long and prosper.
Thanks, Alfie, reading the eulogy on behalf of Greg, Sam's brother, and Wayne, reading eulogy on behalf of Carrie, Amelia, and Evie. Sharing beautiful memory of Sam with us. And this is something very, very touching to come to know such a lovely man, lovely family man, and also a wonderful friend as well. And we know very well the saying from the Ecclesiasticus, say that to everything there is time and there is purpose. Time to be born, time to die, time to sow, time to harvest, time to laugh, and time to weep. You know so well. But then to live through those times is it's not easy at all. One day I saw a caricature of Michael Lunick on the weekend, The Age. And I look at it, I say, wow, it's very interesting. It showed that two men with a machete chasing another man. And when the other man cannot run anymore, they turn around and say, what have I done? They say, you have changed. Change upset us so much. It turned our world upside down. Why? Why do you leave us? We love you so much. How can we live without you? Kubler-Ross, she used the map to express that our grief cycle, dealing with change, not an easy. It's like a riding a wave. We have to live, we go through different stages. Denial, no, doesn't happen, can't happen. Why him? He's so young, so beautiful man, so lovely father, husband, son. Why? Why is that happened to him? And we live our anger to, what? God, where are you? Did you hear anything that we say to you? Then we bargaining, struggling to find meaning. And then go through depression. Couldn't cope. Then slowly we come to accept and find the meaning. That is a circle we have to go through so that we can come out of it. There is no way. There's no way that we say, it's okay, life is normal. No, there is no way. We know to accept our feeling and to go gently with ourselves. Well, not easy. It's so hard. We need to tell story, like Greg just tell story to us, or like Carrie and the girls said, we miss you so much. See how you, how the time that you've been with us is so lovely. We need to tell story. We need to lean on some shoulder to cry. As Greg said, it's okay to cry. We can eat a little bit more, we can drink a little bit more, we can sleep in a little bit more. We can go for a walk on the beach or in the forest. Allow us the time to have some memory. Experience express deep within us. The whole process is long. Could be 3 months, could be 6 months, could be 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. It's not in our control. Does take time. By the way, Sam won't allow us to forget him easily too. The thing that comes to my mind when we have to face the difficulty in our lives, one example come out is this man called Viktor Frankl. He's a victim or a survivor of the Holocaust. He survived Auschwitz and Dachau. Why his parents died, where his brother died, where his wife died, where his children died in the camp. And he survived, and he kind of, through his experience, come out what a therapy it's called. Logotherapy, how to deal with the difficult thing in our lives, how to deal with change, and how to overcome change. One of his saying that he quote Nietzsche, Friedrich Nietzsche, is he who has a why to live can bear with it anyhow. He wrote a beautiful book which is sold millions of copies. It's called Man's Search for Meaning. If we find the meaning, then we can survive. What is the meaning at the moment? I think we face the darkness of death. And we hope that if we find the light at the end of the tunnel, maybe we can bear the burden. From the gospel today, we hear that Jesus say, I am the way, the truth, and the life. What is that way? What is that truth? What is that life? We know that way, that truth is that life is the love, the unconditional love, the love which is so giving of ourselves for the well-being for the others. This is self-sacrificial love. That is the way, the truth and the life. And we know that Jesus has died and has risen. And so we hold on the hope that one day Sam will be risen again with Jesus. Because the God who raised Jesus is the God of love, the God of life, the God who saves. By the way, his life for us is a life of love. Love for his wife, love for his children, love for his mother, brother, his family. Beautiful love. Just like to show the family on the red car, I know that he loved the red car. And often when we sit on the car, you used to tell the driver, you slow down, why you run too fast? Why you have to turn this way? Turn right, turn left. We know very well, the driver know his way. He don't listen to us at all. But we know that he give us a wonderful time. Whatever he do, he show us so much, so wonderful time as a family together. I got a friend who is a photographer and who used to take all the star trails. So this is one of, to express this, the wonder that Sam has shown us in the family through different experience, through different expression, different way of he enjoyed things or even hating things, make us laugh. Very colorful, very amazing the way Sam is to us. This is a statue of La Pietà, which was created by Michelangelo, put in the Basilica of San Pietro in Rome. Mary holds Jesus at the foot of the cross. You could imagine, she wondered, why is it happened to my son? What has he done? That he died a terrible death. I think still have filled up her eyes. She can't see anything. Just the sadness in her. She never knew that 3 days after, Jesus was risen from the dead. God, the God of love, the God of life, the God who saved, have raised Jesus from the dead. And so I believe that at the moment, Sam has passed away from us. We live in the dark and we can't see any further. But if the whole thing is a mystery, just like the mystery of the galaxy in the big sky. We only stare at it, but we don't understand the beauty. Where is it going? How is it lasting? St. Francis, the man of poverty, but also a man of spirituality. He wrote a canticle of the creation where he praising God. Praising God for everything in the world is so beautiful. He called the sun, brother sun, and the moon, sister moon, something so close to us. And sometimes we say, well, sun is a moon, it's a thing. But then for St. Francis, it's my brother. A part of creation, as I am part of the creation. And he called the fire is brother wind and also sister water. We are in it together, in amazing creation of God. He praised brother fire and sister earth, our mother earth. It's nothing strange to him. Even death, he called it sister death. Thank you for sister death, because through this second birth, we come to eternal life. The first birth, when we were in our mother womb, and we say, this is the place to be. There is no life outside our mother womb. We feel so comfortable. We die if we get out of it. Here we are in this wonderful creation of God. So beautiful to look at our mother who look at us and smiling at us. Wow. I cannot believe it. And here we are. We say, this is the place to be. There is no other place outside of this. Everything becomes nothing. But through the second birth, we see God face to face. That is the eternal life. Not until we die, but from the creation until the end of creation. The God of love, the God of life, the God who saves. St. Paul keeps reminding us, what no eyes can ever see, what no ear have ever heard, what even our mind will never conceive, is what God prepared for those who love Him. And everything is revealed to us through Christ's death and resurrection. So we gather together to give thanks to God, a beautiful gift. God have created Sam and brought him into this world. And we enjoy the time being with him. Now to God he returned. Once the hand have given us such a beautiful gift, no longer need to look at the hand, but we need to look at the moon, the God of all mercy, the God of all creation. To that God, we come together to give thanks, and also we entrust in that God and commend Sam to that God, the God of love, the God of life, the God who saves. We have the prayers of the faithful. I'd like to invite Jessica, Matthew, and Tiffany. So my dear friends, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall never die.
Loyalty, and joyous spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who mourn Sam. May his family and friends find solace, knowing that although he has now departed from this earth, he will be eternally reunited with those who have gone before him. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the oncology staff at John Faulkner Hospital, who cared for Sam with incredible compassion and professionalism. May their service be richly blessed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who cannot be here today, those interstate and abroad, especially Sam's younger brother, Greg. Our thoughts and prayers are with you. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May Sam's loving mother, Francesca Lazzaro, find strength and comfort in the tender embrace of her family and friends. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we pray for Sam's daughters, Amelia and Evie, as they carry on his legacy. Know your father is always watching over you. Lord, hear us.
God, hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. At the Savior's command and from my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Deliver us, Father, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant us peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and glory of yours, now and forever. We pray for peace. Lord Jesus Christ said to your disciples, Peace I leave you. My peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reigns forever and ever. May the peace of the risen Christ be with you all. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. You can bow to each other. Yeah? Please sit it. We have a video clip to show up Sam's life.
come to the moment, the final commendation. We use different symbol of incense as our prayer to God for him. Also, remind us of his body, the stand for eternal life.
Our response is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul.
Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul.
May Christ who call you take you to himself, my angel lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Father, into your hands we commend our brother Sam. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life and live with Christ forever. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother Sam to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and be with you and with our brother Sam forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angel of the Lord accompany you. May the martyrs welcome you on your arrival and lead you into the holy Jerusalem. May the choir of angels come to meet you and with Lazarus, who was poor here on earth. May you enjoy eternal rest. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and may your perpetual light shine upon him. Again, in our tradition, we have a cross to keep here for Sam, and after the first year we give the cross to the family. Like to invite Harry Perry and the two girls to come with me to the cross.
It's been a long road getting from there to here. It's been a long time, but my time is finally. I can feel a change in the wind right now. Nothing's in my way, and they're not gonna hold me down no more. No, they're not gonna hold me down, 'cause I've got faith of the heart. Come alive at last. I will touch the